We can dance if we want to. We can leave your friends behind. Cause your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine.
My camera's being a little bitch. It says change the battery pack. I take it out, put it back in, and it works. It's telling me the batteries are dead when they're not. Anyway, yeah, that's what this video is about. I did recently make a video. You noticed before, when I pulled this, the whole shroud would kind of shake back and forth. But now, I can push the whole mower by this thing and it doesn't move. I figured out what the problem was. See, last year I put a new head gasket on this, and, well, I'd actually put two new head gaskets on it, because the first one, I ran for a while, and then the head gasket blew out again. So, what I had to do was put a new one on again, and then remember to retorque the head bolt down. So, I was doing that this morning, and I noticed around these bolts, there was a crack going up here, and a small crack going here, and there's a crack here, and a large crack there. And I said, that must have resulted from the shroud shaking back and forth all the time. So, I got out the welder, and I welded washers onto here and here, and on the inside I welded up the crack. And then I just ground them so I can bolt this back on. And I threw a little paint around the edge of it. I won't do it right now, but I'm gonna... Actually, I think I have some white paint, so maybe I will. Just strip this down and repaint it white. I'll save the decals, though, because they're in very good shape. And just put some duct tape over them. And then sandblast it. But anyway, the reason it was shaking back and forth was not only because there was a bolt missing here, but on these Tecumseh engines, right up under here is a plate that bolts underneath the flywheel, and then that plate has nuts welded onto it, which these bolts screw into. And that plate had come loose. So I retightened that plate and I put new bolts in here, and now this is just rock solid, which it never has been since I've owned this machine. Shitty. So let's set the camera case over here, and I guess the camera right here. Let's see, what kind of a view do we got? Let's start it for you. I'm just gonna choke it by hand because the throttle cable's all fucked up. Helps to turn the ignition on. She's running good. I think it was Duke that said something on Skype about this electric start thing. And, well, this engine never had electric start. And I got looking at it, and there's no place to even bolt a starter on here. And the flywheel doesn't have a ring gear. Yet. I mean, obviously, this isn't the original shroud, but I have the original shroud, and the original shroud still has that. And there's no plate under here, so I don't know. What the fuck was I talking about? I hate losing my train of thought. I was actually thinking about trying to put electric start on it one time because the tiller that this came off of had electric start. If you're wondering why this is like this, I turned this because this used to be. So the pull cord would be up here. But, the tiller had electric start, and I had the flywheel off the tiller as well, but the tiller had the coil on the outside of, it had the coil like right here on the outside of the flywheel, but this has the coil underneath the flywheel, so the flywheel that I have does not work. Actually, I think I scrapped that flywheel. But let me show you the fucked up throttle cable quick. It's just stretched out. It wiggles in here. I'll probably pry this apart, and I'll put a bunch of electrical tape around there, and I'll stick it back in and clamp it down. I'll probably hold it for now, so I'm not putting the cable on it. Actually, I could probably just move the cable way up and then readjust it at the back, but I don't know. This cable's kind of seized up a little bit anyway. Try it one more time. Call it a day. Keep forgetting to turn the ignition on. And it doesn't help, apparently. Camera must have died at some point, I don't know when.